Friends and neighbors, welcome back. This is the third in our series all about making your metronome groove. My name is Rich Brown. This is the Brownstone. And I'm so glad you're here. Now listen, even though this is the third in the series, maybe you're still working with the first or the second video. That's totally cool. I want you to work at your own pace. You're not in competition with anyone. I want you to progress at a rate that you feel comfortable with. Either way, if you plan on working on these exercises today with me, or if you just want to watch, observe, see what the next level is going to be before you move on, either way, we're going to have some fun today. Because in the last video, we took the idea of taking two notes through the 16th note subdivision. Today, we are going to do the same exercise, but this time we're going to take three notes. This is going to be fun. And there's one more level after this, only one. And at that point, all of you are going to be improvising bass lines. I'm telling you, you have to stick around for this lesson and the next video. We're going to have a lot of fun with this. We're working towards this goal of really being able to use the 16th note subdivision to our advantage, so that, as I said in previous videos, there are no weak beats. Everything is of equal value and equal importance and equal accessibility. This is what we're going for. So let's dive right in. We'll start with the first rhythmic phrase from last week, which was the idea of taking two 16th notes. Just those two 16th notes, one E through the bar, right? One E and a, two E and a, three E and a, four E and a. The next step is when we move that, when we shift that to the E, so we have one E and a, two E and a, three E and a, four E and a, one E and so on and so forth. What we're going to do now is the same thing that we did last video, where we kept the one. So now, see what's happening? We're taking our two note phrases, moving them through the bar as we did last week, but now we keep the one and three as we did the week before. So there's this natural progression and addition of notes. We can keep doing this till the cows come home, but I'm only going to work with three notes for this series. So that means if I take this phrase of one E and a, two E and a, three E and a, four E and a, and then shift it by a 16th note to get one E and a, two E and a, three E and a, four E and a, and then add the one and the three, that gives me three 16th notes in a row. So I get one E and a, two E and a, three E and a, four E and a, one E and a, two E and a, three E and a, four E. Does that make sense? Let's take it to the metronome and then take it to the bass. Okay.
One, two, three, four.
So there we have 75 BPM. And now we'll take our three 16th notes and just play to this groove. Three, four. I'm always amazed at how good this sounds against a simple two and four. When you see me playing through these exercises and then a smile immediately comes to my face, I want that to happen for you as well. Because to me, just this simple exercise feels so good. And that's what I want for you guys. Yeah. When you get it right, it feels great. Right? So now we'll do the same thing that we did last week. So now we're going to move those two notes again. At this point, when we do that, we start our second two notes on the and of one. And if we keep the one, then our 16th note subdivision would sound like this. One E and a, two E and a, three E and a, four E and a, one E and a, two E and a, three E and a, four E and a. So we have the one, and then because we've shifted our two 16th notes to start on the and, on the upbeat, we have this new rhythmic phrase. One E and a, two E and a, three E and a, four E and a. All right, so to the metronome, and then to the bass.
One, two, three,
four. Count it out. Two, three, four. One E and a, two E and a, three E and a, four E and a. Establish your comfort with the tempo and the metronome. Count that 16th note subdivision out loud. Three E and a, four E and a, one E and a, two E and a, three E and a, four E and a, one E and a, two E and a, three E and a, four E and a. Then we place our accents. So the accents are going to be one and a. One E and a, two E and a, three E and a, four E and a, one E and a, two E and a, three E and a, four E and a, one E and a, two E, three E and a, four E and a, one, to the bass. Isn't that grooving? I love it. A two E and a three E and a four E and a one E and a two E and a three E and a four E and a. So good. So see what's happening? So now we're going to do the same thing. Move those last two 16th notes again, and this time we start on the ah. This is a very hip groove. This is where we get into like the two-step rhythm, or so it's called. So what happens is, let's count it out.
One, two, three, four.
One E and a, two E and a, three E and a, four E and a. Now we're gonna start our two 16th notes on the ah, landing on the two, which gives us this. One E and a, two E and a, three E and a, four E and a. One E and a, two E and a, three E and a, four E and a. And that is such a hip sounding groove. Sounds like this. Two, three, four. One E and a, two E and a, three E and a, four E and a, one E and a, two E and a. Yeah. One E and a, two E and a, three E and a, four E and a, one E and a, two E and a, three E and a, four E and a. So good, right? So that's it for the first phrase. Now remember last week we had three different phrases that we moved through the subdivision. We had the one E, which is the one we just finished. We had the one and, which we will do momentarily. And then of course, my favorite and yours, the one ah. I can't wait to get to that one. It's gonna blow your mind. Okay. So let's start with one and. I was going to hit the metronome and then I thought, no, I should speak about this a little bit more. So let's talk about one and. That's basically going to be our two eighth notes. One E and a, two E and a, three E and a, four E and a. Now remember, if you remember in the last video, when we shifted that by a 16th note, what happened was we got this phrase. One E and a, two E and a, three E and a, four E and a, one E and a, two E and a, three E and a, four E and a. So when we keep that phrase, one E and a, two E and a, three E and a, four E and a, and then add the one and three, we get this. One E and a, two E and a, three E and a, four E and a, one E and a, two E and a, three E and a, four E and a. This sounds so cool against the backbeat. I'll show you what I mean. So let's go through the process.
One, two, three, four.
Count out the subdivision. Two E and a, three E and a, four E and a. One E and a, two E and a, three E and a, four E and a. Then we add our accents. One E and a two E and a three E and a four E and a one E and a two E and a three E and a four E and a ba 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 ba. Massive Attack, here we go. One E and a two E and a three E and a four E and a one E and a two E and a. Yes. One E and a two E and a three E and a four E and a one E and a two E and a three E and a four E and a. Pretty cool, right? How's everyone doing? Is it making sense? I hope it's making sense to everyone. We are simply taking the exercises that we did in last week's video and just adding beats one and three to each of those phrases. So if that's confusing at all, or if that's a little bit tricky, then go back to the video from last week. I don't mind. I'll be right here waiting on you guys when you come back. So hopefully that all makes sense. Now we'll move to the next phrase. We just played our eighth note phrase, one and, shifted it by a 16th note to give us one E and a. And now we're going to shift that again to the upbeat, starting on the upbeat, which basically just gives us three eighth notes. One E and a. One E and a two. One E and a two. That's it. Very simple groove, very boring groove if you ask me. Goes like this. One E and a two E and a three E and a four E and a, going through the process. Three E and a four E and a one E and a two E and a three E and a four E and a. I do that because I want to make sure that I'm comfortable with the tempo and counting the 16th note subdivision. If I can relax in counting that out without speeding up or slowing down with the metronome, then I can move on to the next step, which would be, you got it, add the accents. Two, three, four. One E and a two E and a three E and a four E and a one E and a two E and a three E and a four E and a one E and a two E and a three and four. One and two, three and four. Right? Those are the accents. And now, take it. A little shaky there. Make it work, Brown. Let's go. One and two. One and two. One E and a two E and a three E and a four E and a one E and a two E and a three E and a four E and a. Simple groove. All right, we'll move on. Because that's not the most exciting rhythm to play. But it is important. It's important that you know all of these, right? So now, when we shift this from the upbeat, we now have to move it so that our two eighth notes start on the ah of one. Again, when we get the E's and the ah's involved with these rhythms, very hip things happen. They just happen. So check this out. If we work it out, we've got one E and a two E and a, one E and a two E and a. That's our phrase. Because we've taken our two eighth notes starting on the upbeat, on the and then shifted that by a 16th note so that it starts, our two eighth notes start on the ah, which gives us one E and a two E, right? So then we just add one and three to that pulse, to that rhythm. And that's what we get. So let's go through the process.
One, two, three, four.
One E and a two E and a three E and a four E and a one E and a two E and a three E and a four E and a one E and a two E and a three E and a four E and a one E and a two. Bop, 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 to the bass. Very cool rhythm. One and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a... So hip, right? So simple, too. That's the thing. So in learning all of these different phrases within the 16th note subdivision, we're not, as I said last week, we're not playing anything new. We're just examining the phrases that we've already heard, or maybe that we've already played a million times. Now we know what they are. Now we can understand on a deeper level what they are and how we can use them in improvising situations, or in situations where you have to write bass lines or come up with different ideas. These exercises can be so useful for those situations. That's why we do this. That's why you're at the Brownstone. All right, let's move on, because that was the last of the second rhythm. So now we'll move on to the third rhythm. The third rhythm being 1E and A. So now we'll take that rhythm, 1E and A, 1E and A, 1E and A. We'll take that rhythmic phrase and then move that by 16th notes through the bar along with the downbeats of 1 and 3. It's a very simple concept. When you examine them, they become a little daunting. When you hear them, they get super hip. And you remember them for what they are. Right? So I hope you can follow along. I hope this is all making sense. And I hope you're having fun, because I feel like I'm having fun right now. This is great. So,
1, 2, 3, 4.
Now, we're working on the third rhythmic phrase. 1E and A. 1E and A. 1E and A. So when I shift that phrase by a 16th note, as we did last week, I get this new phrase. 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a. That's my phrase. When I bring back the downbeat, one E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4. One E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a. So that's the first phrase. Now, we'll do the same thing. Same thing as we did last week. So when we shift that phrase and start it on the upbeat, on the and, we get this. 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a. And then we simply add 1 and 3. 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a. Right? So now let's go through that process again with the metronome. 3, 4. 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a. And then add the accents. 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a. Bop, bop, bop. 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a. 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a. That's so grooving. 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a. I love it. Nice, right? So that was the end. Then we have just one more rhythm. Just one more. So now we're going to start that same phrase on the A, the last beat associated with the quarter note. So 1E and A 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E and A 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a. Already that's a very hip groove. Already. But then when we add the one and the three, watch what happens.
One, two, three, four.
1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a. Again, it's important. Count out the 16th note subdivision. Make sure you are comfortable in that space at that tempo. And then I can move on to the next. Here's the thing. If you're not comfortable, if you do feel like you're rushing or maybe falling behind the beat, that's okay. Go back and just work on that. Go back to the very first video in this series and then just work on that. I will take you through. I'll take you through every step of the way at your own pace. I'm here now, but I'll always be here. Whenever you want to come back to this point in this video, I'll be right here. I'll just wave. Yeah, I am right here. So don't rush. Don't rush to be perfect right away. It doesn't happen. It very rarely happens. This was a process that I had to go through, and I had to fumble and stumble and work on my time, and that's what I did. And now I'm at this point where I feel confident sitting in this chair, bringing this information to you. But if you're not there yet, it's okay. Go back to the first video. Check that out. Sit with it for as long as you need. Move on to the second video. Sit with that for as long as you need. And then when you get to the third video, hey, what's up? I'm still here, man. I'm still here. What's up? Okay, so let's get into this third and final phrase.
1, 2, 3, 4.
1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a. Then I'll add the accents. 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E. Do you hear it yet? You don't? Maybe you do. 1E and a 2E and a. Dance hall time, people. Pure dance hall now. Huh? That's it. Those are all the phrases. Hey, listen, friends and neighbors. I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you're enjoying the process. And I hope it's helping you with your time. Listen, you can always message me in the comments. I will do my best to answer and address any concerns and any struggles that you might be having. I'll try. I'll try to respond to any of those that you might have. I really want to help you on your way to becoming the best musicians that you can be. If you like this video, please do me a huge favor and click like. You don't have to smash like or slap like or shoot like in the face or anything like that. Just click like. The like button never did anything to me or anybody else. I love the like button. So go ahead and just give it a little click and share this video with as many people as possible. Anyone you feel could use the help. And subscribe to the channel. I've got a whole lot more information to give to you. I'm not gonna just talk about, you know, playing to a metronome for the next 10 years. I've got so much to share with you. And if you really see some value in what I'm bringing to you, and you're in a position to do so, you now have the option of donating to the channel, which really helps me to bring this to you. I'm trying to update all the gear so that, you know, I can have better equipment to make these videos. Because right now, my microphone is right up here, which is not the best. So please feel free. I will leave a donation link in the description box. You can click that No donation is too small or too large. And every little bit helps. So if you do find it in your heart, then please feel free. Listen, I've had a blast hanging out with all of you for the last little bit. I'm going to leave you with that. And I'm excited for next week's video because I'm going to have you all improvising bass lines. It's going to be a lot of fun. Until then, my friends, as I said before, like, share, subscribe to the channel, donate if you can. My name is Rich Brown, and I am so glad you stopped by the Brownstone today. Peace and love, y'all. See you next time.